Hello student, welcome to my channel. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. Today we will see some more problems related to SOP in KMAP. So now this is the problem statement. You can see here the problem statement is this is the problem statement, that is we have function of four variable summation m bracket 0, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13. All these are minterms. Now, in the previous my video, I told you, like, when there is a summation m, you have to solve this problem by using, SOP. What do you mean by SOP? Sum of product. That means you have to group once. Please remember, in the exam, they will not mention whether you have to group. Sometimes they will not mention whether you have to solve the problem by using SOP or POA. They will just give summation M. Summation M is just indication that you have to group. You have to make a group of ones by representing these minterms in the table. First, we will see, we will represent these minterms in the table. M0 is there. See, I have used four variable KMAP. This is a four variable KMAP. Vertically, I have taken two variables and horizontally, I have taken two more variables. Let me represent now minterm 0 first. Minterm 0. So, this is the minterm 0. Next, we have 1 and 2. So, this is 1. This is 2. Then, we have 4, 5, 6. Yeah, 4 is there, 5 is there and 6 is there. Then, 8, 9, 8. 9, 10, 8, 9, 10, 12, and 13. Now, grouping. So, first, put one question to yourself. Can you make a group of 8 ones? That is, can you make a group of 8 ones? If not, 4 ones. If not, 2 ones. If not, single one. These are the option. Can you make a group of 8 ones? Yeah, yes, possibility is there. So, let me make a group of 8 ones. So this is the 8 one. This is the group of 8 ones. Yeah. Now, I will call this group as G1. I will call this group as G1. Let me write the answer later. Now, remaining this one, and this one. Three ones are there. So, can you make a group of 4 ones? Anyway, you can make a group of 2 ones easily. But still, provision is there. See, provision is there. You can make a group of 4 ones like this. Right? And I will call this group as G2. Now, which is the remaining one? Only this one is left out. So, I can make an individual group. But still, you know, in the grouping technique, we have one provision, corner group. Like, I can, let me use different color here. I can make use of corner grouping. We have seen in a previous video, like this, and you can make one group of 4 ones, and that group is called G3. Now, what is the answer for G1? G1 is the 8 ones group. You can see here, 8 ones group. So, when you see this 8 ones, ones are spread over all, 2 columns. So, when you see vertically, all variables will get negated. See, 8 ones are spread over 4 rows and 2 columns. So, you have to see 4 rows and four rows and two columns. So vertically, when you see, all the variables get negated. Horizontally, you have to see, because horizontally you have to see only these two columns. These two columns, because 8 ones are spread over these two columns, right? So, which is common here? C bar. So, answer for this one is a C bar. Now, second group is G2. G2, you see, 4 ones, and these 4 ones are spread over 2 columns and 2 rows. You can see here that group is marked by using light green line, light green circle, you can see. So, you have to see these two rows, which is the combination? A bar. So, A bar is the common, and horizontally also you have to see this row and sorry this column and this column, and the combination is a D bar. So answer is a D bar. So one thing you have to see here, you have to notice, my student, when you group 8 ones, 4 variables are reduced to one variable. When you group 4 ones, 4 variables are reduced to two variable. Suppose if you group 2 ones, 4 variables are reduced to 3 variable. So that is the difference. That's why we are telling why you have to group, the group should be bigger always. First think whether you can group 8 ones. When you group 8 ones, you will get a minimal solution, like the variable is a single variable. Otherwise, if you group 4 ones, you will get 2 variables. If you group 2 ones, you will get 3 variables. You may think why he is telling like that. You just think, suppose if I get a single variable, then 2 variable or 3 variable. Suppose assume that I got for one more group, I got something like A, B, C, something. Then while implementing by using hardware circuit, I need here 3 input gates. Here I need 2 input gate. Here I need 1 input gate, which is simple, which is economically feasible. That you have to see. So that's why grouping is very, very important in K-map. So let me go back. So last one is here. You see, last one is the corner grouping. Corner grouping. So in order to avoid confusion, let me delete this other grouping. Now I will leave only corner grouping here. Let me delete other grouping. So first let me delete entire things and yeah, let me write here first. This is one, and yeah, anyway, this one was there, this one was there, this is one, and this one, yeah. Corner grouping is this one. Now, corner grouping, horizontally you have to see this row and this row. So, what is the common horizontal in this row and this row? B bar is the common, right? B bar. Very simple. Vertically you have to see this row and this row. Horizontally you have to see which row? This row and this row. Which is common here? D bar. So this is D bar. So let me repeat here. Vertically, you see, groups are spread over vertically this one and this one. I mean this row and this row. Horizontally, it is spread over this column and this column. So when you see vertically like this, you have to see this one and this one. When you see horizontally here, top side, you have to see this and this one. So this is the answer. Now final answer, let me write the final answer. So final answer is, I will write here, function of 4 variables A, B, C, D, and it is nothing but G1 plus G2 plus G3. This is called SOP. So your answer is C bar, A bar, D bar, and B bar, D bar. So this is called SOP, sum of product. See here, sum of product means, let me avoid this confusion. See here, you can see here, this is one product term, A bar, D bar. And this is one more product term, B bar, D bar, one more term. And in between sum is there, like OR gate is there, in between OR function is there. So this way, that's why this is called as a sum of a product expression, sum of product expression. So this is the answer for this one. Thank you.